waiting at 10 o'clock in the morning because they were afraid if they waited until 5 o'clock to get there, we would run out of food, which we have never done, but some pictures have. So we went to a random number system. There are people who are really not comfortable with that. Again, culturally, we are a stand-in-line sort of culture. And this whole idea of drawing a random number and not knowing if you're going to be first or 100th didn't work. And so I don't know that I would want to see a central organizing unit that would say we all had to be following the same procedures.
I'm not sure I'll get to a question. Maybe it's for the question. I've been an occasional volunteer at the pantry for a while. And one thing I think you didn't talk about that I always think is important to know is the facility. It often strikes me that Wesley has a lot of space, but if you were to choose some place to do this, it would not be the first choice. And I guess the question might be, the point I want to make is that in keeping with your point earlier about, you know, anybody can do something, I think the facility, the fact that that hasn't stood in the way of doing something is important too. And I don't know if there's anything related to that that you would want to point out in terms of, you know, challenges of doing that, you know, when you moved into the back of the sanctuary, if there were people that were concerned about that, anything on that.
I think to answer the question, I think we would have figured out something no matter what the building was like. And yes, I mean, first of all, it's a blessing to have a building that's a block long and as much space as we have. Because one of the things we wanted to have happen was nobody has to stand in line. People coming to get food in that situation, I don't think should have to stand in line. So we wanted to have people be able to sit down while they were waiting. The fact that we have a building that is that big means that, yes, 1,000 people can be sitting in our building, not terribly comfortably, but they're sitting down. And yes, the building has challenges, the lack of handicap accessible entrances, and frustrating and trying to turn the building one way if you can't actually have somebody in a wheelchair come in that entrance. And to answer the other part of the question, actually no. Surprisingly, I have to say I was surprised. When we decided to start using the sanctuary for packing orders for the people who did not want to go through the line, they have to fill out a form and we have a volunteer pack the orders and we do that in the sanctuary. I have never had any pushback. Of course, I do think there are some people in leadership that insulate me from that, so that perhaps I didn't hear any complaints that we had. I want to check if there are any other questions for Dr. Ama, because he's going to need to leave soon.
I would like to thank both of you for what you've done for our community, but I have a question for both of you. What have you guys done to let the people in the community know about the services you've provided?
So let me answer that. So one, of course, is the word of mouth. And then we have also advertised to Spanish-speaking radio, public service announcements. And also we have a web presence and we have Facebook and we have Twitter. But our audience, of course, most of them would not be on the new media. So that, of course, represents a challenge. The other, more recently, we've been also planning to work, putting up billboards. And at the same time, we are sort of conflicted in this because we have very limited resources. So we are only working on Sundays from 1 to 4 because of the resources. And so we will not be able to handle an onslaught of patients. So we want to, again, focus on what we can provide in the best possible way. And that's why maybe I did not highlight that we are only focusing on diabetes, obesity, hypertension, and primary care as our services that we provide, because there are other entities in the community who are providing other So, yes, and to forums like this, so we have talked at church groups, at mosques, at other forums, and so we go about doing that, but also as part of our education and outreach. We also have done at the Havana Farmer Market, and we continue to do that. We have also set up forums at the Hispanic Network Forums, and our colleague here, my mother, has led some of those efforts. And then we also work with the Champaign Havana Public Health District, and that's where we also get some of our patient referrals, both from Francis Nelson and from Champaign Havana Public Health District, and even those who are seen at the court and the public nurse who do not have insurance are referred back to El Sina or the Christian Community Health Center.
Yeah,
that's
good.
So the newsletter, of course, which was the most recent edition, promoted in Spanish and in English, and was distributed at a lot of grocery stores and a lot of the public places in the community. And then we work with the University of Illinois Link Class, the Discovery Class, and other than again our outreach coordinator and instrumental in that. And so that, and again, it's also the coming in of our students from the community, and then they pan out in the community. We put in also flyers at the laundromats, and one of the interesting stories is that one of the women who was seen at the clinic first time, she said she wept when she saw the El Sina Free Clinic open, the 3 years ago, because she had never seen a physician for 6 years and was sick. And so we went around to the community, we also went to the other neighborhoods and then put in flyers at bulletin boards and the like.
I would have to Friday prayer at the mosque, so I do appreciate you listening to me, and if there are any questions, you can be directed to us. And again, I'd like to thank all of you for giving me and our colleagues here from El Sina the opportunity. And please, these are opportunities open for everybody, both to avail it and or to become a volunteer. And there's a galaxy of things that can be done, both for directly with patient interaction and or in other ways in helping out with the graphics or any other things, skill set that you have, you can avail to. And we have Ben Muller here, he's our quality coordinator also. There's a number of ads that we will be able to be doing. And I'd like to thank our medical director, Dr. Shimu Saleh, and Don for giving you a panel with the audience. Thank you.
I would not trade that for that.